Morning Crafty peeps. So we are starting page 5. I think I messed up on the last one and said we were on page 5, but no, we're not. We've only finished page 4, and the reason why I'm kind of going over this again is because it's been a couple weeks since I've started back on this. So basically, we've got page 1, 2, 3, 4. And today we're on page 5. So I have my page already ready to go since we made those first. And I'm actually going to put this to the side just for the moment. I used my solid colored cardstock that is from this Echo Park collection. And this one was called Blue Green. And I cut it down to 8 1/4. Wait, no. Excuse me. 8 3/8 by 7 3/8, it looks like. So, yeah. And then I'm just going to put that to the side for the moment. Then I'm going to grab an 8.5 by 11 piece of craft cardstock for my pocket. And I've already started scoring this, so I kind of have an idea of what to do. So on the horizontal side, so the 11 inch is over here, we're going to score it at 1/2 inch, at 8 7/8, and at 9 3/8, okay? And then we're going to cut off that portion of it after the 3/8. So let's do that real quick. And we can just trash that. And we're also going to now put it back where it is vertical. And we're going to score it at 1/2 inch side, 4 inches, and then 7.5. And then we're going to cut off after the 7.5. And then we're actually making two pockets, so we're going to use one of these later. So on the 4-inch, I believe that's where it was. Yep, the 4-inch, you're going to cut on the 4-inch. Oops, you know, I think I messed up. Well, maybe we won't have a second pocket. Ugh. Yeah, I boo-booed. Okay, well, anyway, so we're going to have one pocket. Traditionally, you would have two. Had I not messed up. Anyway. We're going to go ahead and miter our corners. I'm going to do that now. And I'm just going to slightly miter it right there. Okay. And then on the mountain high side, I'm going to fold it over and burnish in my edges with my bone folder. And then with my distress ink, I'm going to go ahead and distress those edges. Now, if you want to punch your edge, which I'm going to do, you want to do that now so the top of your pocket can have a little decoration. And I'm going to use the same punch I've been using for the last two cookbook mini albums. Okay. Oops, let me go ahead and put this, my mat on here so I don't get all these little thingies in my stuff here. So I'm going to go ahead and line them up and punch. And I'll probably fast forward through this little section here. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and glue it down or use your score tape, whichever one you want to do. I'm just centering it here the best that I can. And just burnish it in and work all your sides here. And again. And I should have pulled out some wipes, and I'm going to do that now. Sorry, I apologize. Give me 1 second, guys. Just pulling out some wipes to dry real quick, so that I have something to clean up with. So I'll have one wet one and one dry one. But anyway, let me lay that out to dry real fast. Okay. Just burnish in all your edges. Make sure they're all down. And then for our piece right here, we'll get that measurement. Okay, so I already have my first boo-boo for the morning. So this is the pocket is actually 3.5 inches long. So we're going to, for our cover for this, I'm going to score it at 3.25. Okay. And I'm using Kitchen Essentials. So 3.25 by, I'm going to figure that out real quick. If it is at 8 3/8, we're going to go to 8 1/4. We're just going to score up to that one line there. Oops, I went a little bit over. Hopefully that won't affect my next thing here. Ah, okay. I'm going to cut on this side because I can see better, but that is not the side I'm actually using. Okay, I did this right. Yes. Okay. You know what? I'm going to take off a slight little hair. I'm not liking how that's looking right there. So I'm just going to take off 1/16 of an inch. And that is basically to this first little line there. So as you can see, it's like a tiny hair. Okay. Let's see if I can put this down just a, there we go. Sorry, I kind of felt like I was out of a view. Okay, so I'm going to get out my distress ink again. And I'm just going to run along here. Going to get out my glue. And let me grab my mat real quick. And I'm just going to glue it up. If it's going to come out, maybe I need to remake another hole. Kind of got a little bit messy there. Thank you. I did not mean to do that. See, I'd be messy, messy today. What is my problem? Okay. Then I'm just going to line it up and place it down here. And then I can just burnish it in with my bone folder. Okay, so now we have our first portion of our base page. We're not going to attach it yet because I never know what I'm going to do next. And I'm thinking about doing like a little swing page. And let's see how we're going to do this. We are going to get another piece of craft paper. Let me see if this is going to fit here. Definitely. So I'm having a brain fart on my measurements today. 7.5. So we're going to score it at, we're taking 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. So if it's 7.5, I'm going to score it at 7 3/8. Or you could go down as far as 7. No, let's do 7 1/4. That's okay. We're not going to be using this little extra piece anyway. So let's just cut that off. Trash that. And you know what? I didn't cut it close enough. So I'm just going to take a little sliver off. There we go. And then we know it's 8.5. So we need to give ourselves our arm, which, or our swing tab, is going to be the 1/2 inch. Okay, and then we know that it's at 8.5. So I'm thinking we should go to, because we have to factor that in now. I'm just going to fold it over so it's not in my way and I don't have to do a whole lot of mathematics. That's cheating. I know. We're going to go to, since I'm going to do a little tab at the end, I'm going to go to 8 1/4. I'm going to cut that off. Now, okay, I'm going to take out my other paper that I just put together and I'm going to glue this on here. Right on the back. So I'm just lining it up. And if you don't want anything to peek through on the bottom, you can line it up where it won't. Goodness, ever since the weather's changed, my glue just has been oozing out of the bottle. Okay. And I'm just going to press it over. And we are going to add a magnet to this. I'm going to have to clean this up with my hand because my towelette is not dry yet. And for my magnet, yikes, that just bit my hand. Good grief. Okay, so I'm going to get my magnet ready. And I'm going to go ahead and put it right over, right about here. So if we're at 8 inches, I'm going to go put it in about 7 3/4. That's just a guesstimation here. I'm sorry. If we open it up, we'll go in at an inch, okay? 1 inch and then at the 3 inch right there. I'm going to go ahead and add some glue. Okay. Clean this up. Not sure why it's oozing out like crazy. That's so weird. And then I'm going to use my tape just to keep it down and make sure it does not move around on me because it's not dry yet. So I'm going to do that real fast. If I can get my tape loose here. Okay. And then I'm going to press my page down. And then I know where the other one is going to be because it's going to automatically flip on there. So I'm going to lift it up for a second and I'm going to add some glue there. And again, I'm going to tape it. The only reason why I do this is because while the magnet is wet, it will move around and I don't want it to. And I'm just going to burnish down the tape so there's no little bumps or weird stuff going on. And I see that I've got a little gap here that I didn't get enough glue there. You can always come back in and fix that. Just pressing it down with my finger. Okay. Okay, so I already cut this one. So you're going to need two of these, okay? And they're both going to be at 7 inches by 8 inches. And then I went ahead and used my solid colored cardstock. This one is pink and cream. And I've already scored it, so all I got to do is just cut it. Okay. I'm missing that where I score it at to cut away from that little line. So I'm going to take off another little sliver. I guess today is just one of those days. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and distress again. And then I'm simply going to attach both of these. And so you have plenty of photo room on here. Okay, so let me get out my score pal again. And I'm going to go ahead and lay this down. Goodness, come on now. I'm getting low on the glue. But I wait until I've used every last drop. And just line it up. And of course, what I love about the glue is that I have a chance to move it around a bit. Make sure I've got everything in line. And I can lay it down flat. Just kind of be careful when you're rubbing around the magnet that you don't want to press too hard. I mean, you want it down, but you just don't want to mash it in there and make a crazy impression. So there we go. And open it up. I'd add this one in here, and I think I want it's down here like that. Okay, now I can attach it to my page. It is ready to go. Now I'm going to need a lot more glue on this one. Make sure it's down. Oops, whoa. Down there, good. Especially around the magnet area. Okay. The one thing I like about using my scoreboard is I can line it up. I know that it's going to be on here straight and I don't have to worry about that. I'm going to open this up and smooth everything down. Burnish it all in. And down in here, inside the pocket, and definitely on the outside. You don't want any lifting. And if you do, take care of it now. Because you'll never remember like me to go back later. Okay, so. Now I'm going to put a tab. I'm probably going to put a tab here, but I'm going to do that at the very end is when I pretty much try to decorate all my pages. I know I did the first one. I'm almost debating on whether or not I should do a pocket here. Feels so bare. Maybe I could do it like this. Almost like the last one. You know what? Let me see if this fits how big this pocket is because I could cut it down a little. Yeah, see, I just need just enough to make sure my card fits in here because I want to have plenty of room to put a photo. So I could do that, which I think I will. Let's see here. You know what? We'll save this for the next page because I don't want to confuse you all. So I'll definitely save that for another page. So now we are ready to start on page 6, which is the back of this page. Sorry, let me just put this back. If I don't, I'll forget. And I'll be sad if I get it all confused. So now I just have to think about what I want to use next and what I want. Oh, yes, I want to definitely do a side pocket page like I've been doing. So I don't know why I'm a little bit delirious. So basically, you'll just follow the same as you have for page 2 and page 4. I'll get that done and then I'll be right back. Good morning, crafty peeps. So we are now going to start on page 7. We're on another day. So we did 2, 4, 6. Yes, page 7. So we're going to cheat a little bit this time. We're not going to use as much cardstock. I'm actually using one of the sheets, one of the 12 by 12 leftovers to make this little piece right here. But of course we have our base page, right? And I'm just going to put that to the side for the moment so I can give you these measurements. The first one is going to be, and I use craft cardstock. You don't have to do that, but it is 8 3/8 by 7 3/8. And as you know, that's pretty much the first mat always that I do at that size. Then this little red sheet that's going to go at the top of this page, okay, and we're going to glue that down, is going to be 8 1/4 by 4 5/8, okay? So that's going to go on top of there, and then we're going to make a large pocket. And I'm pretty sure I kept it the same measurements, but since I've moved on the tutorial, I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, it is 4 inches by 9 3/8. Okay, yes it is. Hold on. Yep, 9 3/8. And then I scored it at 1/2 inch and then at 8 7/8. So 1/2. 8 7/8, and then I turned it to one side and I scored it at 1/2 inch. And then I went ahead and I've already used my punch, and I went ahead and inked them so that we could move along on the tutorial, because I feel like it's dragging on. But anyway, then I want to have a gatefold page. Okay, so you're going to need 2 pieces at 4 3/4 by 7 1/8, and I scored each of these at 1/2 inch. So you have your left and your right. Okay, and then so it's going to go something like this. I don't have all the measurements yet, but I'm close. We're getting there. Okay, and then I decided, hold on, this will actually be, did I mess that up? Because I didn't factor in the width of this one. Let's find out. Hopefully I do not boo-boo big time. Okay. No, it's still right. Okay, sorry, I apologize. Then I went ahead and I wanted to use this as my magnet that's going to go on top of these two flaps, and I will have a magnet underneath here, okay, down below. Okay, and you can either put it underneath here, you can put it here, or you can put it on the back. I always put mine on the back so that sometimes the other magnets don't fight with each other. Then for your, you're going to need 4 mats, okay? Those are going to be, let me see here. Four and 1/8 by 7 1/8. So you're gonna need 4 of those. So I have my 2 that go on the top, and then I'm gonna need 2 on the inside. And then also, I decided to do this. So I'm gonna have my magnet in between here. I went ahead and used the Spellbinders die. It's a Nestability, S is in Sam, 4-249. S is in Sam, 4-249. And I'm using the, I think it's like the 4th one in. So I just want a kind of a little edge, and I already went ahead and inked those 2 just to, you know, take some time off our hands. And I will get this measurement in just a minute, but I'm going to go ahead and start matting. Hopefully, did I ink that? Well, if I didn't, I'm going to ink it now. I try to save paper whenever I can possibly save it. So I'm just going to do like 1/16 of an inch from the top and the sides. I'm going to go ahead and glue that down. Okay. And let me wipe up my glue real quick as I'm pressing this down. And then I'll burnish it in with my bone folder. And like I said, if there's any lifting, which it looks pretty darn good, I'll be darned. What a day this is turning into already, and it's Friday the 13th, and it's supposed to be a bad luck day, but, well, I don't consider it a bad luck day, but a lot of people do. Okay. So I'm going to get one of my magnets ready, and I'm going to put it over here to the side, along with my little thingamadoodle there. And I'm going to go ahead and put my pocket on. Oops. I want to make sure it's in there right. Okay. And I'll tighten it up in just a minute. I just want to get these on here. And it seemed like that fold over fought with me, but I'm going to make it work. I sure am. Okay, so I know that I need to make this one. And I know that this is 8 3/8, so we're going to go 8 1/4 by 3 1/4, and I'll be right back. Okay, so as soon as I said it's not a bad luck day, my video almost didn't save, and it did. So, whew, thank goodness. Okay, anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm actually not going to put this on yet, and the only reason why that is because I haven't got my inside. Oops, well, I guess I got a little too close on that. Let me fix that. So anyway, I need to figure out what I'm going to use for my inside, and I want to use scraps for that. So I'm just going to do those later, but I'm leaving this one not on only because I want to remember the measurement, because I know I never will. So I'm going to get a little clip here. And in the meantime, I can go ahead and get my magnet ready. Okay, so I'm just going to center it in my little scallop thing here. And then put my little ephemera piece on top. And just center that till it looks about right. And that looks pretty darn good. Oops. Okay. Then I can try to figure out, you know, where, what do I think looks like the center? And this looks pretty darn good to me. So I'm going to press this down with my hand, flip it over, and let the magnet find itself. Okay. And then I'm going to lift it, feel around there. Come on, glue. Work with me today. You have not had your last breath yet. Work with me. Oops. Well, I figured the glue in the wrong spot, didn't I? Okay, so then I'm going to go ahead and use my little bit of washi tape there just to keep it in place while it's drying. And now we're going to move on to, no, actually I can go ahead and attach it to my page at this point. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and take that off for the moment. Move that out of my way so I can have my thing perfectly straight. I'm going to get out my score tape this time. And I moved it, so now I can't find it. Okay. And I'm using score tape this time just because these pages are really thick. And so I want to make sure, because I have this gatefold on here. Just want to make sure it's going to stick right. Going to burnish those in. I'm going to cut off any excess. That looks like the only little piece. Get my glue ready. Oops. I try not to do this, but since I'm at the end of the bottle, I'm trying to cover this quickly. As y'all know, I like to use this to line it up. And that looks pretty darn good to me. Let me get back on the inside of this. Wipe up any glue that's coming out. And burnish it quickly because that glue is going to dry real fast. You just want to make sure everything is pressed down. There's no bubbles. Okay, now I can put this back on here for the time being. And we can start figuring out what we're going to do for this page. And I think I'm obviously going to do another pocket page. And what I'm thinking of doing this time, though, is adding my file folder, my small little file folder that I used earlier. I don't know where it went, but we'll grab this one real fast. I'm thinking about using one of these file folders on the top, and then there'll still be a flat page. So we'll get that together, and I'll be back in a few minutes with all my measurements.